What's going on, everyone? This is Michael yet again. Thanks for joining me today here on YouTube. And I hope this video finds you all doing exceptionally well. Now, with that said, I had a chance to watch Godzilla Minus One in the home video release. Now, of course, I saw this film in the theater when it was first released, and I really enjoyed it. A really great Godzilla film. And not just a Godzilla film, but a really great film. But I was curious. I wanted to watch it again, unfiltered, alone, and see how I felt about the film after seeing it again. And I watched it again about 3 days ago. And I gotta say, guys, you know, without a freaking doubt, this is one of the best movies that I've ever seen. This is just a really exceptionally well done, emotionally charged, epic movie. And you'll notice that I'm leaving out Godzilla movie because, you know, it is a great Godzilla movie, but more than that, it's just simply a great movie. And I was just taken aback by just how excellently done this movie is, how emotionally charged this story is, how following our lead character into the traumas that he's going through, the PTS, dealing with life, dealing with guilt. Oh man, this is just some really rich material that's handled so well in this movie. It was so easy to get caught up into this character's life that I just, you know, there were many times, even more so than when I saw it the first time, that I was really emotionally affected by this film. And there were lots of times, guys, and I'm not ashamed to admit it because I am secure in my masculinity. But there were many times during this movie that I got teary-eyed. I did, and as I said, more so than when I first saw it the first time, I got teary-eyed quite a bit in this film. I just felt so badly for this guy, for what he was going through, the situation he was in. And wow, I said it before in my original thoughts on this movie that you could watch this film and take the Godzilla elements out of the movie and it would still be a great movie. And I still feel that way because this movie is just a cut above in terms of what we've seen in characterization in the Godzilla movies. And I'm not at all trying to put down any of the characters in the previous Godzilla films because there are some wonderful characters in those movies as well that I really enjoy. But I would say easily this is probably one of the most emotionally gripping Godzilla films that I've seen, aside from the original film, which, you know, there's a moment in the original film where the mother is praying to or telling her kids that, you know they're going to die, and she's preparing her kids, telling them that they're going to be with their father. And that scene alone was just horrifying to me. And then you had that slow crawl in the original showing the destruction that Godzilla had wrought on the city. And then that hospital scene where people are tested positive for radiation. Just some really compellingly emotional stuff. And Minus One does an excellent job of channeling all that grief and trauma in this film and making it just totally stand out. And it's a film that's, you know, I just was so caught up in it. So caught up. And I've also got to say, the Godzilla elements themselves, excellently done. Godzilla was literally terrifying in this film. Just a walking disaster waiting to happen. And a tragic story. I've got to say, it's just a tragic story in that you have what's happening to Japan in this, and then you have what's happened to Godzilla as a creature in this when he was nuked with nuclear or the radiation, and he became this creature. So, you know, ultimately the blame is mankind. So it's just a tragic story. And, you know, just when you think that you've seen it all in a Godzilla film, what's really kind of amazing to me is that they pull something like this, and it's a story that you've seen before, but it's taken at such a great angle that it seems all fresh and new. And I see it as more of a remake of the original film above anything else. But, you know, revisiting this movie, I've got to say that it was just epic, guys. Just a totally epic film. Now, there are things in it that there are a couple of problems, mainly the survival of the girlfriend. I just don't know how she lived as far as what we saw on screen, because she would have just been swept away. But, you know, him finding her to begin with in the crowd of people who are just running from Godzilla all over the place, how he could even find her or know where she is, it's just amazing to me. I mean, I guess maybe we could assume that the train would have let her off at a certain district and then she would have, you know, exited the train from that area and he knew that that was her exit. But anyway, it doesn't matter, honestly. But I've got to say, guys, you know, just an intensely satisfying movie. And I was just, you know, swept away with this film. This is an excellent movie, And I don't know if I originally said so in my original thoughts of this film, but it would most certainly be in my top five favorite Godzilla films of all time. An excellent movie. Excellently visual, excellently acted. And, you know, one of the things about this movie that I got from my first thoughts in the first video was that someone left a comment and they said something like, you know, how can you praise the acting? Or maybe, you know, now that I think about it, I think it was a Godzilla film, but it could have been something else. But they made a comment of, how do you know the acting's good when you're reading subtitles? Well, you know, I could just tell. I mean, maybe some of you can elaborate on that. How do you know acting's good if you're just reading subtitles? I mean, I've seen subtitled movies where the acting is just kind of terrible. I mean, yeah, I don't know what they're saying, but it seems terrible. But it just seemed like to me that the acting in Minus One was heartfelt and that it had meaning behind it, substance behind it. So that's how I knew. That's the best I can say. But anyway, guys, definitely got to say it was an excellent film. Upon my second viewing of this movie, it was excellent. Totally excellent. Totally gripping. I loved the characters. I loved the crew on the boat. I loved just about everything about this movie. An excellent Godzilla film. Anyway, there you have it, guys. It was a joy to revisit this film. And honestly, I look forward to watching it again. And it's one of those few Godzilla films where, you know, oftentimes I'll just kind of shoot through a Godzilla film and get to the Godzilla parts. But in this movie, I was so caught up with the characters that it's not that kind of film. I want to see the characters too. Thanks for watching, everybody. Take care of yourselves, and I will see you all in the very next video.